Amber Geiger was sentenced to 10 years in prison for the fatal 2018 killing of an innocent black man, Morton Jean, whom she shot when she mistakenly,
allegedly,
entered his apartment, believing it was her home, she alleged. But in a remarkable act of kindness, the brother of the victim took the witness stand and spoke directly to Officer Geiger, saying, "I love you like anyone else." And later hugged her in the courtroom before she was led to prison. The jury reached a unanimous decision on the sentence after deliberating for a little over an hour. The judge, Tammy Kemp, ordered Geiger and her attorney to stand as she read the jury's decision on sentencing. Geiger was turned over to the Texas Department of Criminal Justice to immediately begin her sentence. She could be eligible for parole in 5 years. The sentence appeared to be initially disappoint the family of the victim, Morton Jean. They had hoped for a far harsher punishment for this officer. Several members of the family broke down in tears, shaking their heads as if in disbelief of the jury's decision. But Bolton's brother, his 18-year-old brother, Grant G, took the witness stand and spoke to Officer Geiger, saying to her, "I know if you go to God and ask Him, He will forgive you." He went on to say, "I love you just like anyone else. And I'm not going to hope you rot in hell or you rot and die, like my brother said. I personally want the best for you," he said. "I wasn't going to say this in front of my family. I don't even want you to go to jail," he said. "I want the best for you because I know that's exactly what my brother Bolton would want for you. Give your life to Christ. I think giving your life to Christ is the best thing Bolton would want for you." The young man then begged the judge if he could give the officer a hug. A request the judge granted. He stepped off the witness stand and met Geiger in front of the judge's bench, and he embraced him.
Yes.
As Geiger broke into tears. And not just this guilty woman that broke in tears, but the judge, doctor, and the lawyers, and almost the entire community. Yes. Nobody had ever seen anything like this before in my 35 years of practicing law, said one of the lawyers. Indeed, words are not enough to describe what took place. Let us see if we can show you what happened, eh?
Wasn't gonna ever say this in front of my family or anyone, but I don't even want you to go to jail. I want the best for you.
Today was an extraordinary day in a Dallas County courtroom.
Because I know that's exactly what both of them would want you to do. And the best would be give your life to Christ.
The victim impact statement in the Amber Geiger trial was unprecedented.
I love you as a person.
Both of Mijan's younger brother Brant gave an impact statement to Amber Geiger.
And I don't wish anything bad on you.
He surprised the judge and probably members of his family.
I don't know if this is possible, but can I give her a hug, please? Please?
Yes.
All the deputies in the courtroom looked at each other, knowing that this was a major infraction of the security rules. And then they looked at Judge Kemp for guidance. She made a snap decision and said, go ahead. And so the hug happened. Instead of reacting with rage to the guilty verdict and sentence of 10 years, he pivoted and offered grace and kindness and forgiving. The judge, already emotional from watching Brant hugging Amber Geiger, went to the family and spoke to them and offered them words of encouragement, just out of earshot of the reporters nearby. The judge then turned and went to Amber Geiger herself. She bent down and spoke to her in her ear. We couldn't hear what she was saying at first, but then the judge walked away, went back into her chambers, and returned less than a minute later with a small book in her hand. We quickly realized that it was a copy of the Bible. Then the judge and Amber hug each other. Amber tells something in the judge's ear that prompts the judge to say, "Ma'am, it's not because I'm good, it's because I believe in Christ." The judge continues, "I'm not so good. You haven't done so much that you can't be forgiven." The judge continues, "You did something bad in one moment in time. What you do now matters." Then the judge urges Amber to take the Bible with her as the deputies escort her back to the holding cell for prisoners. At this point, lawyers and onlookers were all tearing up, getting emotional. I was tearing up. No one really could understand what was going on.
It ain't gonna be no peace until justice is served.
But it was in stark contrast to the chanting going on outside.
No justice.
I'd say that was a pretty impactful victim impact statement.
You're going to ask me, look at this again, it moves us. It also moves us, it moves us to tears. When we see this wonderful picture of forgiveness. What we have witnessed from this young man is what this nation and the world need.
Yes.
It's what we need.
Yes.
And beloved, this is nothing more than the revelation of the character of God.
Yes.
This is what we have just seen.
Yes.
And this is what happened on Wednesday. a picture of the character of God was revealed to this nation and to the world. And this is what Jesus came to reveal. And it is only because of Jesus in his life, this young man's life, that he is able to do what he did. Jesus came to reveal the love and the mercy of God for those who hated him, for those who rebelled against him, for those who sinned against him, for those who killed him. And he did something remarkable. He forgave them. He forgave us all. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. And the wages of sin is death. But Romans 6:10 tells us that when we were yet without strength, when we were yet without strength in due time, Christ died for the ungodly. For scarcely for a righteous man will one die, yet preadventure for a good man some will even dare to die. But God commended his love towards us in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. For if then when we were enemies, we were reconciled to God by the death of his Son. This young man was able to forgive his enemy for killing his brother. And notice he forgave her even though she did not request it. He forgave her even though she did not repent and confess her guilt. He forgave her unconditionally. And that act of forgiveness was demonstrated by embracing her, hugging her. And it led her to what? Break down in tears. When she saw such love and forgiveness that was granted to her, it led her to break down in tears. She was now ready to receive the love of God in her heart. And this young man who had all the rights to be angry and bitter towards this police officer, former police officer, for killing his brother, only expressed love and forgiveness to her. This is what moved the courtroom. And this is what moved the nation. And this is what God has done for us. We who were his enemies, who are guilty of sin and death. Yes, this whole nation, this entire world, guilty and stand condemned to death. God has forgiven our sins and has removed the condemnation. For ye are not under the law, but under grace. God's amazing grace, because he has forgiven us. And he has placed us under his grace. Grace does not give us the license to sin, but grace frees us from the power of sin. For sin shall not have dominion over you, for you are not under the law, but under grace.
Amen.
Grace frees us from the condemnation so we can have power over the dominion of sin in our lives. Thank God for the revelation of His grace. This is the grace that ought to move every sinner to repentance. It was this young man's grace that led this police officer to break down in tears. God is waiting for His church, His people, to believe in His love and His forgiveness so that He may reveal His love and forgiveness to the world.
Amen.
Amen.
What we saw in this young man was the revelation of the character of Christ, which will light the earth with the glory of God.
Amen.
This world is soon to be lighted with God's glory. But John the Revelator declares, I saw another angel come down from heaven having great power, and the earth was lighted with his glory.
Amen.
The glory that lights up this earth is the character of God.
Amen. Amen.
And this character will be revealed in the life of Christ.
Yes.
And when John, the one who wrote the gospel, the same one, John beheld his glory, he declared it was full of grace and truth. This glory must be reproduced in God's people in these last days.
Amen.
This is the glory, the character of Christ that this nation witnessed this week in this 18-year-old.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
And this is what, beloved, we are trying to present here at Beacon of Light. The gospel of forgiveness. The gospel is all about forgiveness. But beloved, like this young man, anyone who presents this message will receive harsh criticism.
That is right. That's so true.
Too much grace. Too much forgiveness.
That's right.
Where is the law in all of this? Where is justice?
That's right.
This woman deserves the full justice of the law. He is too soft, and we would have nothing to do with it. No justice, no peace.
Mercy.
No justice,
mercy.
No peace.
Mercy.
Mercy.
Oh, we're presenting.
Beloved, this world is on the road to rejecting the only solution to its problem. The heart of man is becoming cold, yes, but dark and dark. And only the righteousness of Christ will fix it.
That's right.
Only His glory can fix this world's problem. God is seeking to use His people, His church, to reveal His character to the world. Now is the time, beloved, for God's church and God's people to make themselves ready to stand for Him in these last days.
Amen.
Now is the time. The servant of the Lord says, Christ is waiting with longing desire for the manifestation of himself in his church. When the character of Christ shall be perfectly reproduced in his people, then he will come to claim them as his own. Christ of Jesus, blessed be his name. Time is short, beloved. Time is short. God will not wait much longer. If his people refuse to believe in his unconditional love and mercy, then he will use others to reveal his name to the world. And we will be lost. God wants to use his church. He wants to use his people to reveal his character of love and mercy. But we must first believe. Believe that God is so merciful to us that before we even repent and confess, he has forgiven us. Forgiven us of all our trespasses. Forgiven us of all our sins. If this young man could do it, why can God not turn to God? Is this young man able to forgive more than God?
Mercy. Mercy. Mercy.
Whenever we proclaim this good news of Christ's character that he has already forgiven the human race, it is hard for many to believe. You believe that we have to go and repent and confess first. Then God will forgive us. But beloved, the Bible tells us again and again, it is the goodness of God that leads us to repent.
That's right.
God's mercy
leads us to repent.
God's forgiveness. God's grace that has been manifested towards us. And when the sinner receives it and believes it, it breaks his heart. And it leads him to genuine repentance. And when he repents, God removes the sin from his heart. He purifies his heart. But God first forgive, then that leads to repentance.
Yes. Amen. Amen.
That is the character of God.
Amen.
While we were yet sinners, Christ died for us.
Mercy.
He didn't wait for us to repent and confess our guilt.
Amen.
But he has forgiven us.
Amen.
And the evidence that he has forgiven us, the evidence that this young man forgave the officer, he embraced her. He hugged her. The evidence that Christ has forgiven us is the cross.
Amen. Amen.
Cross.
Praise the Lord. Amen.
He hanged on the cross for you. And he hanged on the cross for each and every one of us. That is the evidence that he has forgiven you of all your trespasses, of all your sins. And today, beloved, he wants to impute and impart his character of forgiveness and love into our hearts.
Amen.
When that comes in, beloved, it is only then can we be like this young man.
Mercy.
Only then can we express that type of love and forgiveness towards our fellow man.
Amen.
We will be tested.
Mm-hmm. Yes, we will.
When the gospel and its purity in these last days is restored to the church and in the hearts of God people, beloved, it will shake the world.
Yes.
And not everybody will rejoice. Because many will be saying, no justice, no peace. No justice, no peace. Too much love, too much forgiveness, too much grace. The day the Lord says, if you will hear my voice, harden not your heart. He wants to come in and he wants to live out his life in us. But we must allow him to. We must surrender our hearts to his love fully. Now he who has begun this good work in us to finish it, to perfect it. So you are here today by no accident. God wants to use you as his vessel. God wants to use you in these last days, even as he has used this young man.
Amen.
And the world is waiting to see the revelation of God's will, God's character in his people. And this will be done. The final manifestation that will be given to the world is a revelation of the character of God.
Yes. Right.
Right. That's what the Lord says. For this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached into all the world for a witness unto all nations. Then shall they come. This gospel in its clarity. Gospel reveals the character of God. It will be proclaimed through the whole world. Then shall the end come. May God help us today that we will believe the gospel of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. The gospel of forgiveness. God bless you.
Amen.
We have another amen, folks.
Amen.
I don't know about you. All I was not with joy. Not with joy to hear the gospel of Christ being proclaimed. The gospel of Christ being lived. The life of a youth in our generation. And folks, I'm telling you, I watched this video time and time again, and what seems to stand out to me is how that man, even Christians, I'm not talking about the world, folks, they don't know Christ. So they don't have a revelation of Christ to them. They don't know God's grace and his love. But I've seen blogs of many Christians who denounce what this young man gave. Denounce it. Who will reveal Christ if it's not his people? And how will they reveal Christ? The issue here is that what angered the people the most is that he gave something to someone was undeserving. That is what I heard. She is not deserving of love and forgiveness and grace. Then who is? Who is? That's why it's called grace. That's why it's called grace. It's undeserving. And if all of us got it, then we must give it to somebody who is not deserving of it.
Amen.
That is grace. Let us stand with the use of him 189 as we bring this powerful and profitable message and service to a close. Hymn 189. All that fills my soul is Jesus.